Welcome friends, in this clip we'll show how to use Vlookup to pick up data from a different master file. Let's go to our directory. I have got here this master file for Vlookup. I have got here, this is the file where I have got my, I want to prepare my invoice detail. So I have to pick up price and description from this master file. Let me show the open file. This is my file where I want to prepare product detail or invoice detail. I want to pick up here sales, which I have done using Vlookup formula. I want to pick up here price, but the these things are in a separate price called master file for Vlookup, and this is that file. Now coming back to invoice file, I want to pick up here price, and for that, this is the formula. It begins with equal to Vlookup and open bracket. Then next part, these are all same as explained in previous clip. The product code for which I want to pick up Vlookup. The next part, after that there is a comma. After that there is a in single inverted comma, the name of file. Single inverted comma starts and also square bracket starts. Square bracket ends at the end of name of file. Then there is a name of sheet. And at the end, say again, single inverted comma. All these things you will not have to type. I'll show you how to get it. Then there is the area from which I want to pick up the data from master file. This is B3D8. Let's go to master file and show you the area. This is B3, the product. Column headings are not to be counted in that area. So this is the area, this is B3 and this is D8. So accordingly, this area is here, B3 to D8, and dollar it is inserted automatically. Then there is comma, then from which column I want to pick up price. Again, let's go to master file. My price is in third column within master file. This is it, and we have to remember this blank column is not to be counted for that purpose. In the first column in our Vlookup range from where we want to pick up data or Vlookup master data, first column must have the code for which we are searching, and from that only the columns are to be counted. So since D is third column from B, the column number to be given in the formula is 3. And finally, since this is not a block lookup, so we are giving false, or alternatively we can give here 0 also. You can press here enter. This formula you can see here also. Similarly, I have given formula to pick up description. Only difference here, it is in second column, so I have given here 2. Now, let me show you how to enter this formula by actually doing data entry. It is more simpler than it appears. I'll begin with equal to Vlookup, open bracket. Then I will click here the on the product code for which I want to pick up information. I'll click comma. Then I will have to go to master file. So I'll click here on my status bar on the Excel, and two files are visible. I'll select the master file. And from this master file, I'll select the range. Note that column headings are not to be included in range. And it has automatically taken the master file name, sheet name, and the range area and inserted dollar. I'll click next to it and type comma. Then I have to pick up the price from third column. So I'm typing 3. I'm putting comma again. And I am typing 0 since this is not black block lookup. Alternatively, if I don't want to type 0, I can click on this exact match. It is giving this option. I am clicking on exact match. In fact, I'll have to double click on exact match. Then it will pick up false, which is equal to 0. I'll at the end, I'll press close bracket and I'll enter. So this formula is entered. This formula I can then copy it below. Since here dollar is automatically inserted in the formula, I can copy it below. There is no need to do further modification. So this is the way we can pick up a formula from a different file using VLOOKUP. But one important point to be kept in mind is that this will work so long as both the files are in the same folder and the master file name does not change. In case there is a change in master file, even in master file, there should be no column inserted before the master range. If there is any change in location of master file or name of master file, then formula will become invalid. Similarly, if we want to send this invoice file to some other person via, say, email, in that case, I will have to send both the file, master file plus invoice file, and that person will have to put both the files in same folder in order that this formula to work. These two files, master file and invoice file, I can keep in different folder also, but again, they should remain exactly in the same folder, and folder name or its any of its parent folder name should not change. If they changes master file, if they changes, then the VLOOKUP formula will become invalid. It will show error message. And sending such file to other person will be extremely difficult because he will find it very difficult to create exactly same folder structure. If this is the requirement to keep the master file and transaction file or VLOOKUP file in a separate table, then it is better to keep them in OneDrive or G drive in shared folder and then share a link to the person to whom you want to share the link. So with this, our this clip is over. You can send me any question relating to this WhatsApp. You can send me any question relating to this file on this WhatsApp number. And you can also become what member of this WhatsApp group to regularly receive such updates. Thank you and bye.